Another receiving touchdown, Jet. I mean, you're making it look easy out there.
Opportunity, man. Like I said last week, man, just opportunity. Coach Reed, EB, the play calling, and then Pat, you know, finding me in those plays, of course.
First running back since 1970 to go five straight games with a touchdown catch. Given your path here to Kansas City, you know, 2 years injured in San Francisco, how gratifying is it to you to be able to get into the record book with this accomplishment?
You know, first, it's just a blessing, first of all. But, you know, I couldn't have done any of that without my teammates. You know, O-line, man, they're blocking on a whole nother level right now. Pat on a whole nother level right now. Passed for 5,000 tonight. So that's another achievement for him. And then, you know, the guys on the perimeter, man. When you got guys who compliment each other like that, you know, you got Kelsey, Juju, MVS, you know, all those guys, Sky, you know, it makes it easy. So, you know, Pat, just, you know, he's making his choice right now.
Did you have any idea this was coming? I mean, you had eight receiving.
If I were to tell you I saw it coming, you know, you put the work in. That's what you put the work in all season for. So, you know, when your opportunity comes, you're ready for the moment. And, you know, I definitely done so. So,
Jared, kind of along the same lines, do you ever just pause and reflect on how you ended up being with the Chiefs and what this has done for your career?
Say that one more time, please.
Do you ever pause to reflect on how you came to be here and what this has done for your career to be in this setting?
All the time, you know, like he said, San Fran had the two knee surgeries. I missed 2 years in a row. That was definitely tough for me, just being in that situation and, you know, the unexpected and not knowing. And then, you know, getting a call from the Kansas City Chiefs, you know, me and EB had a good relationship, carried on throughout the years. And, you know, Coach Reed, I've watched him from afar over the years as well, ever since I was little. And, you know, just being able to be in an offense and a scheme like this was intriguing when I first came here. So I was definitely thankful for the opportunity. And, you know, just the preparation, everything is paying off.
How specifically do you feel that Coach Reed has put you in a position to kind of break out like you have in
these? Significantly. I mean, you know, you see the plays that are being called. You know, it's getting me in space. It's finding a way to put me in space. And, you know, the great thing about Coach Reed, not just me, but, you know, all the offensive weapons we have, he does a great job at, you know, finding where everybody's good at and working to their strengths.
You guys have very high standards, right, for scoring every time and all the funk there at the third quarter. Can you put your finger on kind of what was going on there?
Just lack of execution. You know, that's the great thing about, you know, this team, this offense, is that every time we do go out on a series, we want to score. That's the objective. And, you know, when we don't, you know, it's definitely upsetting because, you know, we work like crazy through the week, man. Coaches, they work us like crazy. So, you know, every time, you know, we get a chance to go out there, we want to come away with seven instead of three. But, you know, we'll take three as well.
How has your knowledge of the quarterback position affected your understanding of the game today?
It's helped me a lot. I'd probably just say the most in pass pro. Just knowing, you know, the mic points and, you know, how the protections work out and things of that nature. And just seeing the game from an overall view.
All right. Thank you. Appreciate
Man, look at all these reading glasses on today.
Hey, old people.
What do you want to say?
George, just five sacks in the last six games. What's been going right for you?
Just keep working, you know, for me. Drilling in practice. Felt like I was getting, from an individual perspective, felt like I was getting there, just missing my layups a lot. So in practice with Coach Cullen and Coach Braden, just working on finishing a lot. You know, I play with Chris a lot on the same side. When you play with 9-5, you know, they're going to double him, so that benefits me a lot too. So, you know, it's just a testament to the coaches and everyone around me.
Is there anything specific Coach Cullen's been working on to help you finish a little bit better these last few games?
Yeah, a lot of tackling drills, like second effort to the ball. You know, a lot of the sacks that come for guys around the league is on a second effort, on a counter. So we've been working that nonstop, you know, watching extra film on the in the film room, on the practice field, all that kind of stuff, you know. So.
George, Justin Reed earlier this week said that rookies are no longer rookies. Like, you guys, you personally feel that way?
Yeah, my veterans, you know, Chris and Frank and Carlos said the same thing to me. You know, just no more of those rookie mistakes. You know, you've played enough games. You've played basically a whole season now. We're getting ready for the playoffs now, so that's what it's all about. You know, they got to trust me just like I trust them every play.
What have you been able to pick up from them, either via practice or the game, you've been able to implement to your
own? Just little things, you know, like in practice. I know Frank and I were going this week, for example, just about finishing plays, you know, every single time in practice, you know, finishing exactly how you would in a game. You know, just very little details. It's all about consistency at this level and being at your best every single play. I mean, he's insane. You know, he thinks he's the best interior lineman in the NFL. I don't think it's close. Yeah, he's a beast, man. He's awesome. He's awesome to play against. There's us to play next to. Great teammate. He's super and very unselfish. You know, to see a guy his caliber, you know, he's very unselfish, a team player, great guy to be around, great energy. And, you know, he's the heart and soul of our defense. So,
George, as you think back to training camp, where do you feel like, what areas do you feel like you're much more comfortable now, 17 weeks later?
Just everything, you know, from the run game to pass rushing and everything in between. You know, just little details, things that you might have never seen before, or types of blocks or schemes and understanding different intricacies of the game. You know, and that only comes from experience. You know, I know Frank took me aside this offseason and, you know, going back to camp, you know, talked to me about, hey, you're going to mess up at some point. It's going to be things you've never seen before. But at the end of the day, you get better from those kinds of things and you capitalize. You watch film off of that, and that's how you improve. So that's what it's been about.
George, I wonder if you could take us through a couple of plays. First, your sack, and then secondly, you had the recovery after McDuffie got the sack. Do you have any thoughts of the scoop and score there, or were you straight just going to get on that ball?
Well, you know, I was trying to be conservative, you know, to speak to that. You know, I think, you know, you give our offense, you know, 10, 15 seconds, you know, they could do a lot with that. So first and foremost, to recover the ball, if I had a chance to go scoop and score, I would have done that.
And your sack?
My sack, you know, just you know, see, it was kind of like a play action deal, counter back to quarterback level, stepped up, and I was there to make a play.
On that fumble recovery, just how big of a moment did that feel at the time?
It was huge, you know, going into halftime and giving our offense a chance to go back and score.